No sport celebrates and cherishes stories like baseball. There are countless tales about the major leagues and the national pastime.
The luckiest man on the face of the earth.
But there remains an untold story. An all-American story of a league created out of necessity that would ultimately become a driving force for change. A league that didn't care what color you were or where you came from. The only thing that mattered was, can you play? And these men and women could absolutely play by setting new standards and breaking barriers. They would change the game and this country forever. These are the legends. These are their stories. This is the Negro Leagues. The beauty of the Negro Leagues is that they didn't care what color you were, and they didn't care what gender you were.
This is a man's world.
Toni Stone, the first of three pioneering women to play professional baseball.
But it wouldn't be nothing, nothing without a woman or a girl.
Toni Stone was a tremendous athlete who started playing professional baseball with the San Francisco Sea Lions, then would join the New Orleans Black Pelicans before making baseball history as a member of the Negro League's Indianapolis Clowns. She would join the Clowns in 1953, second baseman. As a matter of fact, she took the roster place of someone you've likely heard his name before. The legendary Henry Aaron.
You got crazy good ball for players. Kansas City Miners and back east, the Clowns.
Indianapolis Clowns?
Yeah, the Indianapolis Clowns.
You're playing second base?
Second base.
Was there a marketing slant to this? Of course it was. But what in business is not about marketing? But it certainly does not diminish the talent that Toni Stone brought to the table. And Toni Stone faced her own challenges playing in the Negro Leagues. Of course, she had to fit in with the fellas, and you had to earn their respect.
She swings that wood just as hard as many men.
And she was certainly able to do that. As a matter of fact, the more they challenged her, the more aggressively they played trying to prove a point that she didn't belong, the better she responded.
The harder they knock me, the harder they keep me, the harder I come back.
First offering is fouled off. Here comes the pitch. Runner breaks for second. Curve in the dirt. Kicks away.
0-2.
That's a wild pitch as he moves into scoring position. Man on second, two down. Wouldn't chase that time.
One ball, two strikes, count.
Kicks and fires. There's a line drive to left field. And there's a hit. Run comes in from second, and it's 4-0.
I guess you could say that Toni Stone's improbable journey into professional baseball had a little divine intervention. Because when she was 10 years old, Toni Stone's parents, who was not exactly happy that she had fallen in love with baseball,
And so they brought the priest to sit her down and have a conversation with her. Well, the priest had seen Toni play. And so what did the priest do? He signed her up to play for his baseball team. The rest, of course, is history.
I didn't know what to really say in Cooperstown. Thank you, Mother. Thank you, Daddy. I don't know what I was thinking then. He was trying in so many ways to stay out of this spot.
A base hit, headed for the plate, the throw home, he'll score, it's 2-0. That's inside, and that is ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-1.
Ball two.
In the dirt. He's in there. So a wild pitch allows the runner to advance. The 2-1. Ripped, but it curls foul. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That's down. One hops off the wall. She's in safely at second. A run comes in on the play.
For Toni Stone, there was already immense pressure to go play with men. But when you step in to try and fill the enormous shoes of a young phenom by the name of Henry Aaron, that pressure is even greater. You see, Henry Aaron had played while briefly with the Indianapolis Clowns and had put on a show for the 3 months or so that he was with the Clowns. And here comes one Toni Stone to step in and fill his roster place in 1953. Now, you can't feel the shoes of the hammer, but Toni Stone rose above it all and played this game tremendously.
Among the league leaders in hitting and stolen bases.
Making history as the first woman to play professional baseball.
Stone steps to the plate, but the base is loaded. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Drops into the glove. Both runners tagging. A big run scores on the sac fly. 3-0. So two down. Now it's the second baseman, Toni Stone. Pitch misses, and that's ball one. That one clubbed out towards left center. That'll be extra bases. One run is in. McDonald rounds third, headed for the plate. Shelton. With a relay throw, she is safe.
The fear that was oftentimes associated with the women playing the game was that they might get overpowered at home plate. But you see, Toni Stone was fearless, so she wasn't worried about getting overpowered. She held her own in the batter's box. But in the field, she was just as adept at playing second base as the fellas was. And she could field her position. Great range, a strong throwing arm. that she oftentimes showcased to the delight of fans who filled the ballpark to see a woman playing with the fellas.
This second base lady is up in the NAL to stay. It's a woman's world.
So two down, and next will be the cleanup hitter, Kent. Ground ball up the middle. In the hole, jump throw. That's the third out.
Toni Stone, in a career that had many highlights, would say herself that her greatest accomplishment was getting a hit off of the legendary Leroy Satchel Paige. But Toni wasn't alone. A lot of Negro League players would also say their greatest accomplishment was getting a hit off of Leroy Satchel Paige because, y'all, Satchel didn't give up many hits. But Toni was so proud of the fact that she stood in that batter's box, stared down the immortal Leroy Satchel Paige, and got that hit off of him. And it was an amazing moment in an amazing career for the legendary Toni Stone.
One up, one down. Toni Stone digging in now.
That's a ball.
Smith stands at second with two gone. There's a swing and a drive. And it's off the wall. Throws to second. She pulls into second as a run scores.
Toni Stone was a tremendous athlete. She was a multi-sport athlete. She played basketball, she played softball, she played football, and she also ran track. Could run the 100-yard dash in 11 seconds. So yes, she had tremendous athleticism. Don't take my word for it. Take the word of the legendary Henry Aaron, who praised Toni Stone as a good ball player, or her teammate here in Kansas City, Ernie Banks, who could pick it himself, who would say of Toni Stone that she was smooth in the infield.
Big spot here as Toni Stone digs in with the bases loaded.
Before Toni Stone and Ernie Banks were teammates, they actually played against each other. The Monarchs and Clowns played each other several times in 1953, with Ernie as the shortstop for KC and Toni at second for the Clowns.
Little with a relay home, the tag, and he's out. But on the play, two runs cross the plate. The wind of the pitch. Out towards right center field. That one gets down for a hit. Runner aboard on the leadoff single.
He was left in a small town, being called a town boy.
Well, that must have been hard for you then. I mean, to follow your dream like that.
Yes, but I sold it now. It's you one because I got mine.
In 1953, Toni Stone made history when she became the first woman to play professionally with the men in the Negro Leagues. And while that is certainly a milestone, she opened the door for her fellow Indianapolis Clown colleagues, Connie Morgan and Mamie Peanut Johnson, as young ladies who make their way here to the Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, many of them softball players, the look of awe that they carry with them when they are introduced to these three pioneering women who played baseball, and they played baseball with the fellas. And every so often, someone will say, well, one day a woman will play in the major leagues, or a woman will play professional baseball. And for me, I'm like, no, it won't be one day. The question is, when will it happen again? Because it already has happened. What we are doing is fueling dreams. We're fueling the possibilities that come from this incredible story of amazing athletes who overcame the obstacles that were in front of them to go after their dream. For Toni and Mamie and Connie, it was the dream of playing baseball, and they were able to fulfill that dream. And the Negro Leagues gave them a platform to do just that. This museum, it is also about fueling dreams, hopes, and possibilities.